This is the story of Father Joseph Guedra. His story needs to be remembered. Before the Second Vatican Council, Father Guedra was a priest in good standing. He was nationally known as an advocate for making Good Friday an official state holiday. Here we see that President Harry Truman sent him a letter in April of 1947 stating that the president hoped that the people of the nation would participate in church services on Good Friday. Here we see a photo of him, to the right, discussing the initiative with President Eisenhower. But then the Second Vatican Council happened, and with it came the introduction of new and illicit sacraments. In 1969, the bishops were getting ready to put a halt to the Tridentine Mass. By Easter of that year, Cardinal O'Boyle was laying down the law to Father Guedra, telling him that he could no longer say the Latin Mass in public. The old priest resisted, but the cardinal stood firm. So Father Guedra took a leave of absence and moved out of his old friend's diocese to Northern Virginia, where Father headed up a new independent church. For the first year, Father Guedra swore his new little parish to secrecy. He would only tell them that he had made a promise to the cardinal and any publicity would harm the church. Like a band of gypsies, the laity followed him in the clandestine roving mass, first at a public elementary school and later at a meeting room at Tyson's Corner Shopping Center. In June of that year, however, Bishop Russell and Cardinal O'Boyle denounced the parish in a public notice in Catholic newspapers. Bishop Russell warned Catholics that Father Guedra had no authority in Northern Virginia. He could not validly hear confessions or witness marriages, the bishop claimed. The parish was declared off-limits for Catholics. The sacred obligation to attend Mass was not fulfilled by hearing it at the new church, the bishop claimed. But the church flourished anyway. The bishop's renunciation made the parishioners more resolute, defiant. They still had quo primum. Janet Natch of the parish board explained, "I'm not in mortal sin. I believe our bishop is the one in mortal sin. He should read quo primum. I don't feel that I left the Catholic Church. I feel that the Catholic Church left me." Father Guedra eventually established another church in the area, this time holding services in his own home. Interestingly, the Novus Ordo Church had been holding Novus Ordo Masses in homes for several years. Here's a photo from 1969 showing Bishop Fulton Sheen saying the Novus Ordo Mass in a Protestant home. However, here we see an article that Father Guedra was fined for holding Mass. Father Joseph E. Guedra, who was 71 years old at the time, was appealing a $250 fine for holding services in his own home. Father Guedra's attorney said it wasn't any different of a situation than any of his neighbors holding a party on a Saturday night with 10 parked cars on the driveway and streets. One of the parishioners testified that the service involved no loud noises. Asked why he attended the service, a parishioner said that it was the only place in Northern Virginia where the Latin Mass was celebrated. Father Guedra's lawyer said that the use of a private home for services would continue each Sunday because it's not necessary to obey an unconstitutional law. The story about a Catholic priest being arrested and fined in Fairfax, Virginia for saying a traditional Latin Mass startled a good many Catholics. Such a thing was unheard of before the Second Vatican Council met. Catholics in the United States were allowed to attend guitar masses, hootenanny masses, red masses, children's masses, or folk masses, but bishops outlawed the true Catholic Latin Mass millions of Catholics had learned to assist in celebrating. Reverend Joseph E. Guedra, the priest who was arrested and fined, was bootlegging a traditional Catholic Mass to the faithful. Here's an article from the Cincinnati Enquirer asking whether the civil courts were being used to enforce Pope Paul's rule. It says that the torch for stupidity in religion had passed to Fairfax, Virginia, where residents and officials were persecuting an aged priest for praying in the wrong place. Twice they convicted Father Guedra of violating a zoning ordinance. The 71-year-old priest was one of a few in rebellion against the Pope's order to quit using the ancient Tridentine Mass for public worship in favor of the new illicit Novus Ordo Mass. The article asks whether Father Guedra was being persecuted in civil courts to enforce the Pope's order that the once universal Mass be used only for private prayer. It asks whether such a thing could stand a constitutional test based on freedom of assembly and religion. Here's a letter in response to the article that said it was about time to start doing something about religious persecution in our country. Please note that it was and still is the Novus Ordo Church that was practicing the religious persecution. The case went all the way to the Supreme Court, where the conviction of the 73-year-old priest was upheld. Father Gedra's story is one we shouldn't forget, because we shouldn't forget the Novus Ordo Church suppressed the Latin Mass. If it wasn't for brave priests like Father Gedra and those who came after him, as well as the brave laity who refused to go to the Novus Ordo Mass despite the Novus Ordo churches telling them that they were in mortal sin, there wouldn't be any Latin Masses available to any of us nowadays. We also need to remember that the only reason that the Novus Ordo Church eventually allowed parish or FSSP Latin Masses was to keep people away from the independent Latin Masses that weren't under its control. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be back again within a week with another one. But in the meantime, please check out my Facebook page and my Twitter page. Every day I post additional content that you won't find on this YouTube channel. And also, please pray for the church.